go through those doors, Izuku. You will surely die if you do. Izuku wakes up in a panic, completely confused. What the hell was that, he thinks. It was a weird, circular-shaped building. And a voice telling him not to go inside. And he'll die if he does. It was quite the dream, Izuku would think, but his mind can't dwell on that thought much longer, as this was the day he would end up going to the USJ building. It was his first field trip at UA, his favorite school, his dream school, as it was the school where he would graduate and end up becoming the number one hero. At least that's what he thought and what he wanted to become. However, he would not become anything close to that. Izuku would get dressed and would start to go outside to head over to the UA building. It was a 30-minute walk from his house to his high school, and he didn't want to be late, as if he was late, he could quite possibly be left behind and not get to go on the field trip. So he decided to continue on walking. 2 hours would pass as he would see himself walking out of the bus and marveling at the nice-looking building. It was circular-shaped and had 2 sets of double doors that were led up to by a staircase. As him and his classmates walked up the staircase and right up to the doors, as they would meet the hero 13. Now, Izuku's dream had been long forgotten by now, as he had much more important things to worry about. He didn't want his mind to dwell on something so long, even though it was fiction. He didn't have to even think about it. It wasn't real. It wasn't going to become real. It was all just something inside his head, a dream, a thought. Something that was not real at all. So Izuku had completely forgotten about his dream. He had no reason to remember it at all. So when he entered the building, no memories or anything from his dream came up. The only thing that quite shocked him, however, was a purple portal opening up and many villains just coming out of it, as they would all start to run towards the children and the young heroes, while a purple portal thing that transported the villains there would also appear right under Izuku and his classmates. Him being shocked could not jump into action in time, as he would fall through the mysterious purple portal and would land himself on the ship with his classmates Suyu Asui and Mineta. As he would be standing there wondering where and how he would get out, where he was, and what his plan should be to go help Aizawa. As he saw in the distance Aizawa defeating many villains that were all just standing there confused after seeing most of the heroes disappear, at least the heroes in training, that is. Now, Izuku would be standing there as he would then ask both Asui and Mineta to tell him their special abilities and what they can do, as they would then tell him that they have either a frog cork or some weird type of sticky hair type thing that comes off of their head. Now, from there, Izuku would make a plan, just like in canon, and it would escape off of the ship while also trapping all the villains in the water. However, when he would get to the center island, an alarm would start going off. It was quite strange to Izuku, an alarm just randomly going off at random. He had no clue what to do until he heard the words fire, 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 fire. This alarm would repeat this phrase, this word over and over again, as he would just get stuck in the moment, completely in shock, not knowing what to do, as his classmates would jump into action and would start running for the door, as a massive fire would burst out. Many of the villains would find their way back through the purple portal, evacuating, while Izuku would be stuck there, completely confused, as his classmates and his teachers would end up evacuating, his teachers and most of his classmates forgetting about him until they would look back to see him standing in the center, just completely confused, not knowing what to do. one such classmate being Uchako Uraraka, as she would yell for his name, "Izuku, come on! You gotta get out of there! You might get yourself killed!" She would yell as Izuku would come back into real life, as if he was in the dream world, completely confused on what had just happened. He would look around to see the entire building he was in burning to ash, as rubble would start falling from the ceiling. The ceiling would start caving in on itself, as Izuku would start running to Uraraka, trying to grab onto her hand, as the staircase had been completely destroyed in an explosion by the villains. As Izuku would use his quirk to jump up, trying to grab her hand, as he would miss but grab onto the ledge. As Aizawa would grab Uraraka by the shoulders and would yank her through the door, leaving Izuku there holding on to the ledge, as he would look up to see her gone. The doors were shut, sealed tight, as he was completely confused. Izuku would run and start banging on the doors, yelling for someone to help him, yelling for them to open it, but the heroes wouldn't listen, thinking it was just a villain who was immediately going to attack them, as Izuku would then get blown back by an explosion right by the door, which had already been barricaded so nothing would happen to them. Izuku falling down what used to be the flight of stairs, landing down completely just paralyzed. He couldn't move at all, as he would just be left there to feel the agony, the burning, and the smell of his burning flesh by the flames that were all around him. Izuku had nothing to do but just sit there. He had nowhere to go. He couldn't move. The shock and the fatigue on his muscles, he was laying there, completely lost, just crying. He was going to die. Surely he was. This was where his dream would all flood back to his mind. "No," he would say. "This can't be. This was the dream I had." As the fire would finally catch on to his skin, burning it, wrinkling it, as Izuku would start screaming in agony, yelling for someone to help him, yelling for God to save him, yelling for someone just to end his poor life that was beginning to drift away in the flames that were just taking him away in this pain. As Izuku would just be sitting there, lost, empty inside, his friends left him there, had forgotten about him. He was just burning. Why? Why were they doing this to him? Is this just some kind of sick joke? Was this a prank? That's what his mind was thinking, trying to escape the thought of his friends leaving him there. The thought that his friends had just forgotten about him in time of crisis, that they were just going to leave him there to die. The fire would break out even more, destroying everything around him, as the ceiling would finally collapse, as the roof would cave in on itself into the building, as Izuku would just be left there staring up at this falling rubble from down onto him, as a massive explosion would break out, as Izuku would then erupt into some type of green flame, but it was still hurting him, very much so, as a figure would then appear through a gray blobby portal that kind of looked like Play-Doh, as this figure would then look down at Izuku, just completely wondering what had happened to the boy, the poor soul that he was, as Izuku had now just been lost in his own consciousness, losing consciousness, as this figure would then come pick Izuku up and take him through the portal, as they would then drop him down on some type of hospital bed or operating table, as the doctors would then start putting different things into him, making sure that he stayed alive, as they could hear the steady heartbeat. It was very faint, though, on the heart monitor, as they would then start giving analysis, saying what they needed to make sure Izuku stayed alive. One of his arms had been crushed by the falling rubble and was surely not going to survive. As they told All for One, this person now in this suit of armor, that this boy was going to lose his arm but could surely survive. As All for One would just be standing there, completely in shock, he had gone back to see if the Nomu had been lost. The Nomu didn't come with Shigaraki and Kirigiri through the portal, but all he saw was a burning boy that was yelling for help, who would end up losing consciousness right before he got there, as All for One would just tell them to do whatever they can to save the boy. It was just incredible. The people he had despised, the heroes, had just left somebody there, not even going to save him, not willing to go back in a burning building, risking their lives to save another. It was quite strange. All for One would leave, needing time to think about this, as Izuku would be left on the operating table, just screaming in agony. He had nothing else to do. It was a way to vent through the pain that he had. It was crazy how much pain that he had suffered from this fire. However, the doctors discovered something crazy, insane. His blood, it was hot. Hotter than anything they had ever seen. It was hot just like fire. And it was as if he had just awoken some type of cork. A cork that would turn his entire body into some type of fire. A fire within him that could heal him and that he could even use. As they would leave him be, just sitting on the operating table, completely in pain, seeing what would happen. And a couple hours later, they would see that he was all healed, missing an arm, however, as they had to amputate it hours before. Now, All for One would walk back into the room to see Izuku, who was sleeping there, just completely needing to gain back energy that he had lost with the flames that he had used to heal himself. He had awakened a new cork, but with a cost. He had lost the cork that he had gained from All Might. Sure, he still has that cork, but it was deep inside him, locked away by the new flame cork that he has. As All for One would then wake the boy up and ask him some few questions, like what his name was and what he was doing at UA. This is where Izuku would realize how his friends had just left him there to rot and die. It was a reality check for Izuku, how not everything was happy. Sure, he'd been bullied for most of his life because he didn't have a cork, but things started to look up, and then it just took a drastic downfall. It was insane how things could go so well and then go so wrong at the same time. He just took time to comprehend everything that had been happening, while All for One would then tell Izuku some shocking news. He had awakened his cork, a cork that was locked away deep inside of him, much like One for All was just now to Izuku. As All for One would tell Izuku now that he is a flame cork that can heal him and do many other things, Izuku would smile knowing he would have a cork, while also just being displeased that his friends had just betrayed him. All of them were like family to him, but just to leave him there was insane. To leave him there to suffer was a thought Izuku couldn't realize in his brain. He was going to surely need many days to realize this and to think on it. As Izuku would then sit there wondering, waiting for something to happen, waiting for something big to happen, he had all the news he needed. His friends abandoned him, and he had been saved by a villain. His thoughts had been changed forever. However, All for One would ask Izuku something, ask Izuku to join him. Izuku would actually dodge the offer, telling All for One that he himself will help him, but he will not commit many of the villainous acts against the people. As Izuku would start to tell All for One something that All for One really hadn't thought about. The people didn't forget about me. The people didn't betray me. The heroes did. It's the heroes who really are at fault, not the people. That's why I wanted to become a hero. I wanted to save the people from villains who were attacking them for no reason. As the reason they would have to attack someone, they would attack the heroes. The heroes were the people that were just forgetting about them, leaving them on the streets to suffer, much like the heroes had done to Izuku just a couple of days, maybe even hours ago. It was insane, and Izuku had no clue why it was that way, but it was. The shocking reality that quirks had kind of twisted the minds of everyone, thinking heroes were bad and villains were just doing stuff for no reason when there really was motives, as Zuko would then be left there to think about all he has done, just think about what his choice should be. He will surely join them, but should he go back and destroy UA for revenge? Well, he would have to train his quirk, though. As Izuku would then walk off, having nothing else to do. And that's where this is going to be left off, guys. I hope you guys did enjoy it. And episode two, will hopefully be out tomorrow. I'm not quite sure. It will probably take me a little while to edit this, depending on how I choose to edit it. But yeah, I thank you all for watching, and goodbye.